What's up guys, the Ultimate Joshua, and I'm back for another video. And today we're playing some more survival in Minecraft Survival episode 4. So yeah guys, we're playing some survival. This is a kind of a long video for you guys, and this is kind of a long video because this is actually part of some 30 minute footage that I had recorded. It was a meaty sort of footage. A bunch of stuff happens. As you can see here, we are going to get a dog. So, a bunch of okay stuff happens, but I still decided to record it. I cut it down to 20 minutes. And, this is the footage of what we recorded. Some of it is cut up, some of it is fast forwarded. So, this is not too much of a voiceover. This is like a voiceover in some parts, but just so it doesn't get boring for you guys, I will not be doing a voiceover during the fast forwarded part. And we are gonna be continuing on with the survival series. So as you can see over here, it's raining, and we also have got ourselves a dog, which is pretty good. And now we're gonna be just going back to our house, taking the dog along as well. And we're going back to our house now. Actually, the dog does not follow us, and I go back to check if the dog is coming with us or not. And here he is. He's outside the door, and for some reason he just doesn't want to come in. He's probably scared of our other dog, which I was supposed to name him, but we didn't. And he's kind of afraid, so I decided to break the door because he is not coming in. He doesn't come in, and I'm trying to seriously get him inside the house, but he's seriously not coming in. He's just like, I don't know, he's just waiting around in the rain. And I break the door off, and here I make my first cut of the video. So I just cut up this part, and now I've just fed him some chicken, trying to get him to just come inside, just not be annoying, just make it a nice episode. Because I don't know, maybe he's afraid of this guy, but I don't know. I decided to leave him alone for a bit now and get ready to. I was actually gonna go mining for diamonds in this episode. That happens. We still have to do a lot of stuff, which is crazy. I rummaged through my chest to find a name tag and go to name this guy. But for some reason, I can't really name him, which is the weird part. I try to make him stand, try to make him sit. It's just not working. I'm holding the name tag in my hand. Oh yeah, and here's me. This is another cut of the video. I'm trying to get him to get into the house again. And I try to build a little bit of a doghouse, but as you can see, it's pretty shabby. It's pretty shabby of a doghouse. It's not too much of a doghouse. And here's me making another cut of the video. This video has a lot of cuts because this is a really long footage. So I didn't decide to name him because it was kind of useless. I tried to do this stuff again. It's kind of annoying that you can't name him. If I'm being a noob and not knowing how to actually name him, do leave your suggestions in the comments below. We're gonna just continue to name him for the rest of this time. And I'm trying to get him to sit and stand and try and see, like, how do we name him. I've crouched at this point as well, and as you can see, my frustration's getting out of hand. So I put the name tag back into the chest and start to prepare for my great mining expedition today. And I just rummage through my chest, just flipping up and down. So we get out our pickaxe, and now we just I just accidentally hit him. I take out some rotten flesh, give him some rotten flesh to eat, and I go and sleep because I realize it's night and my device tilts a little bit. So yeah, so here we go. We are done over here. So we just get out. I'm like, dude, I've had enough of these dogs. I gotta get out of here now. So I just see this dude is following us again. So for some reason he's following us now, and I go back to the house and I decide that yes, finally I actually wanted to bring some food. So here's the second cut of the next cut of the video. I cut to me going straight to the mining cave, and I realized that this was in the next episode. This was in the last episode, which was actually with Cardfight. I mined a bunch of that stuff. We found all those resources. I still haven't smelted half of them. Yay! So here we are, just hopping around. I've got some sweet berries. I've got an absolute ton of sweet berries. So since I realized you can eat them, I just took them. So here's me getting some sugarcane. And now we're just gonna hobble along. We're gonna get some more sugarcane over here because I wanna know. I think you can make paper, I think. I know I'm being a big noob and not knowing my crafting recipes. I find another berry bush over here and decide to take the berries. I don't wanna go into that bush again like that episode. boy, that was annoying. I see another dog and I decide I've had enough of this stuff. I ain't going back home to grab a bone and then, come back. So I eat some more of my berries because I am pretty hungry. These berries do not have the best efficiency, but they work if you have a ton of them. So I'm just going around now. I'm just trying to find a hole for myself to mine in. So we're trying to find a hole for ourselves to mine in. We find some logs. We find some wood. I actually not brought an axe on me, so that's pretty weird. And here we go, we have found our hole. I also crafted some torches, which about 40 torches I crafted. I place one down and I decide to start on my little mining trip. My torches goes into the wrong place. So I started off on my mining trip, which is pretty cool. So we start to mine, just mining along. So we're just continuing to mine, and yeah, we're just gonna start making a staircase. So I decided to just go down to the bottom, and now we're just gonna make a staircase mine, like, you know, like a staircase mine, so we can like probably reach the bottom and then probably do some other type of mining. I know there's not a lot of types of mining, but whatever. Okay, so here we go, we're just mining along now. So continuing to make a staircase, and here is another cut in the video around here. And now here is it's not a cut in the video, it's just a weird thing. Yeah, so I'm mining some gravel. I'm kind of scared of gravel because gravel can fall on you and it can, it can kill you, which I am super scared about, and that's why I don't really like to mess with gravel too much. So I just mine it with my hand, and I continue to make my staircase. I've got down a good amount of levels now. I've got down to 44 compared to the, I think it was 50. We're at 54 or something at the surface. I get my pick back because I'm mining this gravel with my hands and mining the rest of the stone with my pick. And then I see there's like an opening over here and I see something lit up. I think it's an epic structure, but what do I see? Well, it's a bunch of gravel. And then I try to explore it and I see some epic lava. So now I know I can land this jump if I try and do it nicely. There's water below, so I just try and make myself a little bit of a bridge. And this happens. I'm like, dude, if I had to fall in there, it would have been the end. Like, I would be like, no. I don't have a lot on me anyway, but just the loss of my torches and my berries would be pretty pretty unfortunate. So I mind a little bit. I don't want to go straight in. I light a torch and I see some iron over here. I grab my pick and I get that iron. After that, I mine a little bit more. I'm trying to get the best possible angle on this water, and so I jump down, and I jump down into the water, and I do see some gold over there, but I decide not to take it. I'm like, nope. So I try to block off this water, try to make a little bit of a staircase. I also see some redstone and some iron over here, so I decide to take the iron. And so here's the part where in the video where I'm trying to explore. So this part goes a bit long, and that's why I just fast forward this part, which is coming up now. And yeah, so enjoy this, guys. So welcome back, guys. We are back. Hope you enjoyed that little fast forward over there. We are done mining all of this stuff. I see a little bit of a creeper and I see a ton of mobs, so I decide to kill them all. There's some cave spiders which can hit you with some crazy poisons, which is crazy. And yeah, so we have mined all of that. I see a creeper over there. I don't decide to tackle it. I just decide to let it blow up. We take a decent bit of damage, and I see a spawner. So that is pretty cool that we found a spawner. I do not actually have any intentions of making a mob farm though, because this spawner, it's completely unintentional. I've just literally just found it like in the middle of nowhere. So I've got poisoned, and I don't have a lot of stuff on me, but I mean, I don't have a lot of health on me or hung or food. So I eat my berries. I'm on half a heart with the poison, and as you know, poison doesn't really kill you, and there aren't any real mobs mobs that are gonna do some actual damage. Otherwise I would have died in this place. So I see the spawner. I've placed some gravel down because I wanted to get my sword, but I actually couldn't. So I gain a little bit of health, and then I go in for the rush around here, and I break a few. I think I'm gonna do this. I swiftly swing my sword, get a bunch of them. I get poisoned a bunch of times, and then I finish this dude too off. Break the spawner immediately so that it doesn't harm me anymore. I then light a torch in the area. See that there's a bunch of cobwebs, and absolutely crush all the cobwebs. Well, you can't crush cobwebs. You can absolutely like tore through the cobwebs, because there was a lot of cobwebs, like literally a lot of cobwebs. Those spiders had been doing some work, and unfortunately, guys, maybe I didn't check properly, or maybe it was just wasn't there. I checked till the last cobweb, but there wasn't a chest, and I was pretty disappointed about that. Here's another cut in the video, and here's the part where I see there's water and an absolute ton of zombies. I also see a minecart with chest, so I break that part of the mine shaft, and yeah, if you didn't realize already, yes, we are in a mine shaft. So I break that part with a piece of flint. I know that's a weird way to break stuff. It unleashes more water on me, which is it's weird how it did that. So I clear off the water in that path. There is still water up ahead. I don't know why I didn't light a torch, but I clear out that cobweb with my sword. I also finish off the water, and here we go. We are in the big fight. At least a whole army of zombies comes leashing at me. I mean, unleashed at me. You can say that as well. I look into the darkness, and then I kill that dude. I quickly open the chest, and I got Smite 1, which is a pretty decent enchanting book. Get some torches as well, and a small stick of iron. So I kill that zombie villager, and eat my berries, because I'm pretty low on health, and these guys actually do damage. So I'm not sure how I pull this off. I'm on 1/2 hearts, and I finally realized that yep, there is a spawner over here, because these guys are spawning like crazy out of nowhere, and I try and make a bridge, but I do this epic spawner break, and it's pretty epic. Like from I know it's not epic for pros, but from the top, I just take my pickaxe and break that spawner. I know that there's gonna be a chest in here, unlike the spider spawner, which was, it was just disappointing, man. And I got a golden apple, which is just striking gold, literally. And also I get an epic enchantment book. This has some crazy armor enchantments, which is absolutely mind-blowing. It's like out of this world. And yeah, guys, that is kind of the episode. So if you guys like this video, do drop like, and if you guys like my videos, do subscribe. And yeah, see you guys next time. Bye. Oh yeah, and stay tuned for the next few episodes.